What's going on, guys? Philip at Trade Genius. Hope you guys had a great weekend. All right, so this is going to be an update on Bitcoin, the price of it, and I want to go over some things. So we'll take a look at the expiration chart here, and also we'll take a look at the technicals on the daily and look at our gap chart, look at our delta chart. That's important. And then last but not least, we're going to look at the S&P 500, and I want to talk about that, where this thing is likely headed and how that's going to affect Bitcoin. All right, so let's dive into this video.
Trade Genius.
All right, guys, really quickly, we have some time left on our specials. Again, if you are looking to get in the room, have some guidance kind of through all this volatility, this is $299 for a year. We normally only do that on Black Friday. So that's 12 months. You're in the room with us. You get the indicator for TradingView and all of our signals. And it's good just to be in a room to talk about what's going on with all the volatility. So if you're thinking about getting in, getting started in trading, we have options that you can get started with very little money to start building up an account. Get used to trading. So anyway, check that out. All right, let's dive into the charts. So this is our chart that shows us the last Friday of every month. That's what these red lines are. That is our CME expiration. And remember, we talked about if you're going to run up into it, usually you get a move that fades the run. So if you're running up, it'll fade it to the downside. Likewise, if you're running down, you'll get a bounce up or fade that down move up. So that's what we had happen here. We talked about that being a possibility. And in fact, on the day of the expiration, we had a bit of a drop and we're seeing some follow through now. So that's just something to keep in mind when we are approaching that last Friday of the month. What direction are we heading into that? Because typically, for various reasons, that will get faded. Now, if we look on the daily chart, I'm just going to look at the daily chart right now. The stochastics are, I drew this line here, that's the expected move. When we get this formation, it rolls over, you can expect to see another move down. If you look at where we're at now, you'll see that we're just above this volume void here. So that means there wasn't a lot of volume in this area, and price tends to backfill these areas. And you see them in the chart here at various levels. But I think this level down here in the 5,400 to 5,600, I think is a pull for the price right now. So keep an eye on that. But I think that's what we could see, especially if we see market weakness here beginning of the week. We got a big old gap on our Bitcoin CME futures. And currently the middle of that gap is 63.55. A lot of times what you'll see is price react to those half gap levels. We also have another half gap from a while back at 61.85. So just keep those levels in mind. It's good that we have a gap higher, because I think once we're done messing around with these lower levels, as you can see, this volume void, we have a low volume area here at 55.30 on the futures. Again, I think that's going to be a big draw this week to fill in that area. But again, I would expect another bounce up, and this gap gets filled once we're done backfilling down into this support here. All right, now the delta chart, again, if you guys aren't familiar with this, we cover this quite a bit, but if it's this pinkish shade color, we're looking to fade any pop. So you'd be fading first this WMA20 around the 6150 area, 6145 area. And then beyond that, you'd also fade the 6360 area. When we get the constant sub-zero reading, a lot of times you're going to see that at the end of big pullback areas and consolidations, you'll see it. Normally, this is not under zero. So that tells me we've got a larger pullback and consolidation going on here, and ultimately we'll move higher. Keep in mind, we still have minor capitulation that has not given us the green light yet. So when that does too, I would expect we'd start seeing this delta move north of zero. And so we'll keep an eye on that. Last but not least, I want to talk about the ES relationship. Well, ES is the S&P 500's futures, but I track, you know, for the sake of tracking the charts versus Bitcoin, it's nice to use the futures, because the futures will trade after hours. It's the closest thing we can get to 24/7 charts, because Bitcoin never sleeps and the markets take a break over the weekend. So I like to compare it to, instead of the S&P 500 index, I like to compare it to ES. ES1 is what the futures are called in TradingView. So anyway, you'll notice we topped out February 20th in the stock market and rolled over, and Bitcoin largely has followed suit. So, you know, what I look for at this point in time is, in bear markets, when you get a bounce like we've had the last week or so, you know, this bounce that we got up in the markets is 21%. That's perfectly in line with how recessions start. You get big sell-offs and then big bear market rallies. So a 21% move up in the market seems gigantic for a stock, for the stock markets, but in reality, that's what we usually get when we get these big sell-offs. You've seen it in the 2000s with the dot-com bust, and we saw it in 08. So I think there's a big risk for the downside to roll over here, and that's going to weigh on top of Bitcoin, because as you can see, these market moves are weighing down on Bitcoin. And again, we've talked about that, but largely in these sell-offs, there isn't a lot of safe hiding places. Most people will go to cash or bonds. And even though gold, Bitcoin are store of values and considered safe havens, a lot of times they will act like that. But when you're on a risk or liquidity event like we have here globally, all assets will get purged because you get liquidations after liquidations from large holders, get the tap on the shoulder, get margin called, they got to sell it all. So a lot of assets will just get hit regardless of how the market may interpret them. Now, the one thing that we want to do see is where Bitcoin might start to break away. But really, we want to look at that on the weekly. And so what we're looking for is where Bitcoin on a weekly holds this low, makes a higher low. So you're going to look for something like this and then higher. Okay, so you're going to make a higher low, even though the market dumps to lower lows. Okay, that's going to be your key that A, there's a decoupling. Watch for Bitcoin and gold to go higher. And then B, you're going to notice the market will probably make some lows, do this, and then in a month or two, start getting out of, you know, putting in a bottom and going higher. So that's what I think the game plan is. A lot of times in recessions, that's, you'll see that relationship happen with, you know, we have gold to really to look at for that behavior. And that's typically what we would expect to see. So just bear that in mind. But know that when you have this big bear market rally like we've had here, this 21%, the next thing you're looking for is typically what you'll see is another move down 30%+. All right. So I think sub 2000 to 1800 is probably going to be an area where you would start seeing a lot of people look to get into stocks. But this really is dependent on the virus. Next video, we're going to talk about the virus and its effects and where the light at the end of the tunnel is. But I'm going to show you some metrics that I look at with regards to the virus. And then you can kind of help, you know, put things in a framework as far as where this thing is going to end and how long will that affect the economy going forward. So anyway, that's my thoughts here starting the week off on Monday. Hope you guys had a good weekend. And again, if you appreciate what we do, please hit like and subscribe. It really helps us out. And if you're interested in joining us in the room, go and head over to tradegenius.co and check out those packages over there. All right, guys, thanks for watching. Take care. Trade Genius.